my fellow citizens. At this hour, American and coalition forces are in the early stages of military operations to disarm Iraq, to free its people, and to defend the world from grave danger. On my orders, coalition forces have begun striking selected targets of military importance to undermine Saddam Hussein's ability to wage war. These are opening stages of what will be a broad and concerted campaign. More than 35 countries are giving crucial support, from the use of naval and air bases, to help with intelligence and logistics, to the deployment of combat units. Every nation in this coalition has chosen to bear the duty and share the honor of serving in our common defense. To all the men and women of the United States Armed Forces now in the Middle East, the peace of a troubled world and the hopes of an oppressed people now depend on you. That trust is well placed. The enemies you confront will come to know your skill and bravery. The people you liberate will witness the honorable and decent spirit of the American military. In this conflict, America faces an enemy who has no regard for conventions of war or rules of morality. Saddam Hussein has placed Iraqi troops and equipment in civilian areas, attempting to use innocent men, women, and children as shields for his own military, a final atrocity against his people. I want Americans and all the world to know that coalition forces will make every effort to spare innocent civilians from harm. A campaign on the harsh terrain of a nation as large as California could be longer and more difficult than some predict. And helping Iraqis achieve a united, stable, and free country will require our sustained commitment. My fellow citizens, the dangers to our country and the world will be overcome. We will pass through this time of peril and carry on the work of peace. We will defend our freedom. We will bring freedom to others, and we will prevail. May God bless our country and all who defend her.
About 1,000 meters to a front on the left flank.
Officers and sailors of the USS Abraham Lincoln, my fellow Americans, major combat operations in Iraq have ended. In the Battle of Iraq, the United States and our allies have prevailed.
To date, none of the Iraqi regime's alleged weapons stockpile has been found.
You repeatedly assert that he had the chemical and biological weapons. The question is, why do you continue to assert that that he had them if we can't find them?
I think the administration asserts it because the international community concluded that Saddam Hussein had not accounted for the huge stocks of sarin gas and VX and anthrax that he previously had, knowing that he used chemical weapons against his own people. That's why we've asserted it, because all the reporting indicates that it is true.
Iraq's governing council held its inaugural meeting at the former Ministry for Military Industry in Baghdad yesterday amid tight security. The 25-member group was not elected, but appointed by the U.S. administration in Iraq.
And this sometimes results in unintended consequences, which the military says it can't avoid. Civilians sometimes get caught in the crossfire. They get shot, or worse, they get killed. Last April, when a crowd was demonstrating against the American presence in Fallujah, at least 15 of the protesters were killed by U.S. troops. Since then, the army has had an increasingly difficult time putting down the insurgency. Today, when American forces enter Fallujah, they are greeted by graffiti that says Fallujah will be America's graveyard.
Iraq is to be free and a peaceful society. One part of the country cannot remain under the rule of assassins and terrorists.
We will hunt down the criminals. We will kill them, or we will capture them. U.S. commanders made a somber prediction. The street fighting could be the heaviest since Vietnam.
Our purpose is to get back the city of Fallujah to the people of Iraq. We are to clear this city of the terrorists and the criminals. Oh.
American unit into the city, and were quickly surrounded by Zakharian suicidal fighters who'd stayed behind when everyone else had fled. American units were stalled entering the city. The further we fought, the more we were on our own. So we'd have to go back, onto the streets, through ghostly houses the soldiers thought they'd already won, looking for fighters hiding in the crevices.
The dirty business of urban warfare began as the main force entered Fallujah. The battle for Fallujah is shaping up to be the toughest fight American forces have faced, not since the invasion of Iraq, but since the Vietnam War. For many of these young Marines and soldiers, it's their first taste of combat, and the adrenaline is pumping.
Security, go! Two mate, hit it!
Come on. got friendlies on the road!
Empty houses. With night coming, they had no way out.
Firing as much as they can, so you're literally in the middle of a gunfight.
Go ahead.
Two more Marines were in that room, cleared it out. They had AK-47s, RPGs, and everything. They cleared it out.
Let me ask you from the beginning again. What happened here? This is a mosque, and they were holed up here?
Yes, sir.
And how did this go down, basically?
What happened was I sent my first team, we came in. We saw five or six guys standing here. We came in and cleared this out. And I saw that building over there. I sent my other team over there. They cleared it out. They saw nine guys with weapons. They unloaded on and out.
So these guys were probably killed by one of the tank rounds from the main gun?
No, these guys right here were killed by that team.
Okay. These were the ones in the back room?
Yes.
Okay. But there were people in this room as well?
Yes. Those are the ones that are back there. There's one dead and five wounded.
So this is going to be, frankly, the Fallujah is going to help in getting the election in time. And those who try to obstruct the progress towards democracy and elections are finished. They don't have a safe. They don't have a safe haven anymore. They'll be brought to justice, and the people of Iraq would enjoy, inshallah, their democracy and moving forward. Indeed, there are some destructions, and this is not the fault of the government or the multinational force. This is the fault of those who used Fallujah and the people of Fallujah as hostages. And we don't allow this. Our first and far most important task is to defend the lives of the Iraqi people. And this is what we are determined to do, and also to progress with the political process.
An Iraqi city where some of the fiercest fighting took place in the early years of the Iraq War is now in the hands of forces linked to Al-Qaeda. Insurgents have seized Fallujah in western Iraq. This is the worst violence against the Iraqi government since U.S. forces left the country in December of 2011.
Fallujah has been home to a brutal insurgency since the Iraq War. In 2004, more than 100 U.S. Marines and soldiers died here fighting the militants. Colonel Ahmed told us they never really went away.
This is about as close as Iraqi forces can get to the ISIS front line. That line of palm trees about 200 yards away, within range of mortars and sniper fire.
Iraqi forces trying to retake Fallujah from ISIS are running into stiff resistance. They faced a counterattack south of the city and some of the worst fighting in the government's week-old offensive. Fallujah has been under ISIS control for more than 2 years. Charlie Daggett has been to those front lines.